PKE, Public Key Accelerator. The computation of cryptographic public key primitive are related to ERISA, Diffie-Hellman, and elliptic curves over the Galois field. PKE can be used to accelerate a number of public key cryptographic functions like ERISA encryption and decryption, ERISA key finalization, CRT-ARC decryption, so Chinese reminder theorem, the digital signature algorithm and the one with elliptic curves for the signature generation and verification. We've gone Diffie-Hellman and Diffie-Hellman on the elliptic curves. Regarding the capabilities, in ERISA and Diffie-Hellman, we can have operand up to 3136 bits, and for the elliptic curves, we can go up to 640 bits. The interface of this IP is classical with register, but also a memory of 3576 bytes called PKRAM. It will be accessed thanks to the IHP interface, and it's where you will put your argument and where you get the results. Availability of this IP is on the WB family and also the L5. The block diagram, though the PKRAM, I already told you about it. We've got a PKI control register, so it's where you will put which operation you want to achieve. You've got the status registers and clear flag, and we've got three individual maskable interrupts. Two for error when you try to access an unmapped address, and another one if you try to access a PKI RAM while there is a PKI operation in progress. And we've got the normal one who just indicates that the end of an operation. So you can get the result in the PKRAM when you receive such kind of interrupt in this and check the flag in the status register. The PKI providing many arithmetic functions, as you can see. So what we are most interesting for the ASR, for example, is the modular exponentiation for sure. And I want to give you a couple of words about the fast mode. So to you, the fast mode is when you are going in the Montgomery domain. So it's just a way to accelerate modular exponentiation if you are using the MEM modulus for everybody. So I would say you have to prepare your parameter and the Montgomery parameter computation first, and then the modular exponentiation could be used in fast mode. But you can see there is many basic operations that could be speed up and could be interesting depending on which algorithm you want to use. For the elliptic curves function, we've got the check of a point on a curve. You've got the scalar multiplication also in fast mode, and direct operation like ECDSA signature generation and verification. Here, I just want to give you a reminder about the theory on the ERISA. You've got the key format, quite usual for those one. If you are not familiar with Chinese reminder theorem, here we will need those parameters. So you can see computed from those one. If you are using OpenSSL and generating an ERISA key, you will see those values pre-computed in the key generated. So it could be quite useful. Here is just an example how to create an ERISA key and how to encrypt and decrypt. And you can see that we can accelerate many of those operations thanks to our PKE. For sure, for the encryption and decryption, it's just a modular exponentiation. And we've got one operation for the CRT decryption. So that means all those operations could be done in one operation with the PKE. Quite easy to use, frankly speaking. For the ECDSA signature generation, here you've got the algorithm. If you want to do it, I will say point by point, you can do it and you can accelerate the basic operation. But you can also use one operation, which is a CDSA signature generation available on this IP. Tips, I will say some information that is in the reference manual, but I want you to really be well aware. Take care about the input argument and how you will dimension them in the PKRAM. I put you some information that is already in the reference manual, but it's important to have this in mind. Also, all of those constraints is hide if you are using the HAL, but if you want to go at the low level, that you will need such kind of information. Caution, I think it's more important, remember to clean up the PKRAM when operations are finished. If you are using PKE, that means you are in a cryptographic domain, and you probably don't want the result to be available to an unsecure code. So remember to clean up this RAM when you finish all your operation. Regarding performance, I give you just extract of the WB reference manual. You can see the difference between the normal mode and the fast mode for the modular exponentiation. It's quite important, so it could be quite interesting also for you. for the ECDSA signatures and verification. So those numbers are in a clock cycle. As you can see, the numbers are big, but asymmetric cryptography require a lot of resources, okay? So even in hardware, it takes some time. It's much more better than if you are doing it by software for sure, but always think that it's really, I would say, required a lot of resources. Regarding availability across all our family, as previously said, it's available on the L5 and WB family. Thanks for your attention.